Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube Draft here on ChannelFireball.com. Vintage Cube is home to powerful cards like Mana Crypt, which is what we will be taking. Mana Crypt is a great card in basically every deck. It's not quite as good as Soaring because the drawback of dealing damage does matter, but still very, very good. Lets you get out ahead of your opponents and play some really powerful cards starting from turn one. Got Mana Leak as well. It's a decent card. Night's Whisper. Ooh, we'll see if Dark Ritual can wheel. There's Dark Ritual and a Lion's Eye Diamond, so it's possible one of those wheels. Just in case we draft Storm, not saying I will or won't, but we've got options. Ooh, after starting with Mana Crypt, both Coalition Relic and Is It Signet are quite up my alley. Is It Signet is powerful because it's the best Signet. Red Blue's the best of the color pairs, but Coalition Relic, I think, is just a better pick, especially when I don't know which direction I'm going. There's also Scarab God and Teferi are both very good 5-mana plays, so is Mystic Confluence. Chart of Course is decent too, but pretty easy Coalition Relic. We've got outs to be Storm. We've got outs to be Splinter Twin, Blue-Red Wildfire. There's just like a lot of different kinds of decks. Blue-Green, you know, or Mono-Green Ramp that these cards all go in. So I like starting with some pretty open-ended cards. And, ooh, where do we go from here? Well, I like Time Warp, but I like taking it once I have a bunch of like Planeswalkers, not right now, or cards like Courser or Oracle Moldiah. There's Glenlyn or Archmage, which I found to be a very powerful control card. You just get this out early, you can kind of squelch other combo decks or control decks. Mire, which is fine. I would be more inclined if it was a blue duel, of course. And then there's Grim Monolith, which kind of makes me want to go that direction because they don't have access to tons of colorless mana and maybe can draft like an artifact-based deck or a wildfire deck, something that leverages all this mana into a powerful effect. All right, now we've got Avenger of Zendikar as a powerful mono-green option. Same with Wallroots. Baleful Strix is good, but it's multicolored. I don't love that. I do like Miscalc. You can also cycle it, which means it's the kind of the perfect counter for a more combo-y deck or more proactive deck. Because when it's not good, you just cycle it. So I like Miscalculation. I'm pretty happy taking that. Ooh, here is exactly where we want to take Metalworker. I know there's the Ogwell too, but I think we're much more inclined to be Metalworking, and we could draft a Mono Brown deck, so the artifact-based deck that plays a lot of big things. Plowunder's still here, so green is open, and Spellpierce is good too, but I'm just going to take Metalworker here, and we'll see where we can go. We've got a good start in terms of mana acceleration here, so I like where we're looking. All right, here we don't have any artifacts, but there is a Turnabout, which could be good in a combo deck, though not really where I want to be based on this. There's Zealous Conscripts, which I'm actually really happy with in general. It's just a really powerful card, can finish a lot of games, and this deck can easily splash Conscripts Kiki, you know, if you end up with like a blue-red big mana deck. There's also Arcane Artisan, but I've really not been impressed with that card, so I'm just going to take Zealous Conscripts here. Ooh, this is perfect. Sullen Simulacrum is great. You can reveal it to Metalworker. It's a way to sink mana into it. Also, it fixes colors, and you can accelerate into it with, like, Mana Crypt. So, yeah. Solemn is perfect. I'm not big on Winter Orb anyway. I found the card to be somewhat ineffective, so I don't feel too bad giving that up. Ooh, interesting. We've got a couple different options here. I like Faithless Looting in general. I found it to be just a pretty good card. But there's also Memory Jar and Inkwell Leviathan. These are both good cards for big mana decks. Leviathan is nice to tinker into if I pick up one of those. But Memory Jar is really strong. It's good with Metalworker. It's good if you have a lot of mana. I kind of like Memory Jar, and it's pretty sweet with Goblin Welder if you can get that, or Duretti. Not a whole lot I want here, but I do like Repeal just in general. So I think I'll just take Repeal over Inspiring Vantage, I guess would be the other possibility. Now I wish I'd taken Inspiring Vantage, because I think I do want to take Teferi here. Teferi is the kind of card you want to ramp into. You can cast off Coalition Relic, so that part's not too bad. Yeah, we've got an interesting start here. Well, I really don't like Enlightened Tutor. I don't want to spend a card and a mana tutoring for something. I will take Greaves. I'm not the biggest fan of Greaves, but it is actually a pretty nice combo with Metalworker. If you can play Greaves and go Metalworker, equip Greaves, use Metalworker, play something big, Greaves that. That is not a bad start. I don't think I'm into Beaumont Courier, so let's just take Fireball. That's a really late Wall of Roots, by the way. I suppose I'm actually a little more likely to play Lingering Souls than Thundermaw, I think, though I'm not very likely to play either of those things. I don't really have any color picked out. I have 6 artifacts, which is nice. Though, was hoping to pick up a few more. I think I'm a little more likely to play black Then green, of course. Both those are white. Yeah, we've got... Ooh, Lingering Souls plus Concealed Courtyard. There we go. Oh, that's an artifact. Spear of Heliod is technically an artifact. This is the kind of deck that needs Signets pretty badly. Oh, there's a Signet. So I've got two main options here. There's Dimir Signet, just because if I'm drafting an artifact deck, this helps convert into actual mana. And it is blue, of course. There's also Splinter Twin, because that is a win with Zealous Conscripts, and I could still be a twin deck. I think, yeah, I'll set Teferi aside for the moment. I think I could just be blue-red twin with a big mana theme as well. I think that having win conditions can be, like a good win condition can be nice. And when you can draw, once you've got a ton of card draw. See, look, now I can just take Simic Signet, because Signets are still good over Ponder and Fiery Confluence, both of which I do like, by the way, but this deck's going to want some Signets. Ooh, there's Ancient Tomb and there's Scalding Tarn. So now I have to decide, do I care more about the twin part or the artifact part? But I think I'm just going to take Ancient Tomb. That card is just busted, and I've got a lot of good rocks to accelerate into it. If I keep the twin as a minor part of this deck, I'm just not that worried. I'll take that, and I'm not going to wield Scalding Tarn. I already know that. Ooh, Tolarian Academy. This might be one of those actual rare Tolarian Academy decks. I've got 6 cheap artifacts in the Memory Jar. Yeah, I'm going to take Academy here. I mean, I like Karn and Phantasmal Image, but I think this is going to give me the highest upside. Probably take Tundra here, even though, I mean, maybe I'll end up on Teferi, maybe I end up with Resto Angel, who knows. I just don't want Jite and Siege Gang or Burst Lightning, so even though I'm not excited about Tundra, I think it's the pick there. But look, now I can take Mana Confluence. That's a concession to actually being interested in you know, having some fixing. Yeah, here's the artifact curve. I need some bigger spells to cast, though. Oh, here we go. Mirror Battlesphere. The Battle Ball. It's also good with the Tolarian Academy. So, oh, there's also a Wildfire. I'm going to take Battle Ball. This deck is not set up quite yet at being a Wildfire deck. All right, let's put my mana fixing over here and see what we got here. We got a ways to go. This deck's got two somewhat disjointed themes and could use a little help here. Alright, here we go. Course of Portal's nice. Basically, this is a lot of words to say you draw 2 cards a turn. I mean, I like Inferno Titan and all, but I need artifacts. I like having some card draw. And Course of Portal is pretty sweet. Not a whole lot of action here. I'm really not interested in Mutavault, but Jace is fine. I'll take a Jace. Why not? I could Spell Queller here if I am splashing white. It's also possible I don't even play the Conscripts from Splinter Twin. I think it's completely reasonable to decide on ditching them. But there's also Sphinx of the Steel Wind. If I pick up Tinker, it's nice. It isn't very easy to cast, unfortunately. I guess I can cast it with Coalition Relic, maybe. I'm going to take Spell Queller. I think there is a chance I end up wanting to not even play the whole twin thing here. Not a whole lot of action here. I don't really want Koth, so I'll take Mishra's Factory in the event that I do end up in a mono blue deck. Just take Scrap Heap Scrounger. At the very least, it's an artifact. Well, I'm not ramming up Excavating or Spy Mastering. I guess I could take Siege Gang in case I end up mono red somehow. That seems super unlikely. Alright, so we've got Conscripts and Twin. I'm just going to put that over here because I don't know how likely it is that I play that. Without that, I have 15 playable. No, actually, I have 12 playables. Well, we've got... If we took Conscripts Twin, I would play Spell Queller Teferi. I do have a Tundra, after all. And these are just a little easier splashes in a nearly mono blue deck. Whatever, I'm not playing any of those cards either. Let's put these back here. This is a weird draft so far. I'm not sure exactly which direction we want to go, but we have a lot of options. We have Tundra over here, and there's Teferi and Spell Queller over here. So let's put all my options here. Because I am at this point going to play Repeal, Miscalc, Jace. I don't see a reason not to play those, especially since I have a Simic Signet, Tolarian Academy, which I have a bunch of blue sources anyway. What am I hoping to open? This deck, strangely enough, does kind of need more expensive cards. Though, obviously, something like a Mox or a Sol Ring would be insane, especially with Tolarian Academy. But this deck needs the, you know, big things, a Wyrmcoil Engine, Karn Liberated, you know, type of action more than it needs, I think, Mana Rocks. All right, what do we got? What do we got? Oh, there's Monastery Mentor. I do like this card a lot. There's Treasure Cruise, but this deck's not really going to put a bunch of cards in the graveyard. Fire is also fine. There's Lodestone Golem. Lodestone Golem is really good with like Grim Monolith or Ancient Tomb, just a way to cast it early. So kind of just interested in that. I think there was a chance I might wheel it, but I'm just going to take the Lodestone Golem. Misty gets me a second Tundra. Remand is just a powerful card. There's also Worn Power Stone, but I still don't have something super big. Let's just take Remand. Remand is just always good. Like, I'm always happy having Remand in my deck. All right, what do we got here? Ooh, Kozilek. That's a big thing. It's also Fractured Identity. This card's really powerful. I'm kind of feeling like I just don't try to assemble this two-card combo and just play these good blue and white cards. Because then I can just like play Teferi and Spellqueller. And I can play Fractured Identity. Kind of like that more than taking like a Spire Bluff Canal. I can't really cast Kozilek if I don't draw Metal Worker. So let's just take Fractured Identity. This card is awesome. It's basically steal target permanent. But you also get the Enter the Battlefield abilities. Like you exile, you know, one of their, like an Inferno Titan, you get their Inferno Titan Enter the Battlefield abilities. So kind of like that. I don't think I want to splash Lingering Souls. Linvala is more of a sideboard card. And this way I can run this off of just like Mana Confluence and Tundra. Not a whole lot of fixing. Probably just a Counterspell here since all these random lands are not going to do much for me. And Counterspell's good. Because I'm thinking of a mana base. Probably doesn't have Mishra's Factory either. Probably just plays like Tundra, Mana Confluence, and like three planes and then like 10 islands. Whew. Well, this is an unexpected gift. Upheaval's awesome, and it's perfect with cards like Mana Crypt, Grim Monolith, Ancient Tomb, Academy. All right, we found our big thing, and this makes me more than sure that I don't need Zealous Conscripts and Splinter anymore. Now that I've picked up an Upheaval, now I really just want to pick up any sort of Mana Rocks that I can find, though. There are none here. There's Resto, which I'm not playing the whole Twin thing. Not that Resto Twin's a combo. It's just Resto Kiki. I can Blink. Spellcaller is actually nice. Blink Solemn's nice, but I might just take Strip Mine. I don't think this is an opposition deck. Maybe I just take Walking Ballista. Yeah, Ballista's just a really strong card. I've been pretty impressed with Ballista. Plus, I can save it with Repeal. That's some good technology. Ah, and here we are. Orzhov Signet. I mean, not as good as a Azorius Signet, but I'll take what I can get. Orzhov Signet at least provides white mana, so I've got a blue Signet and a white Signet, and that is good. I guess Orzhov Signet makes Lingering Souls a little bit better. I've got a Concealed Courtyard too, but I still don't think I want it. Though I might side it in if it's a good matchup for it. Huh. Tezzeret the Seeker. So I don't have that many powerful things to get that are cheap because it sort of doesn't work with Ballista. I guess I could get a cash in for a portal right away. It does add a lot of mana. I'll take Tez even though I don't think I'm going to end up playing Tez. It is something to consider. No, I guess no one's playing green. Badlands doesn't do anything for me. Days, I actually could end up playing Days. I'm not going to main it, but I'm going to end up with 11 islands in my deck. That's more than enough to play Days. Maybe I actually just will play it. It's really good if it's in your opening hand. I like Hanging Back a lot less than Ballista, but I'll take it anyway. And Through the Breach too. There's some good cards that no one wants here. Not really interested in Terramandering. I'll take Thalia as a sideboard card. There are some decks where Thalia really makes it hard for him to win, like Storm, for example. The Storm also makes it hard for itself to win by being Storm. So you don't usually need too much help to beat them. I say as someone who plays Storm quite a bit, to very little success. Do I want Lightning Greaves? It's good with exactly Metalworker, but it's kind of cute with like Lodestone Golem or even Battle Ball. Doesn't sound insane to want to play Greaves, because I do have an extra slot, because now I do want to play 17 lands here. Sure. No one's playing White Weenie either. I don't think I'm supposed to play Thalia in this deck. Is Hangerback better than Lightning Greaves? I think I'd rather just try Greaves first. I could also play Scrap Heap Scrounger off of a couple black sources, but a 2-mana 3-2 does not do much for me. And Dauntless Bodyguard is our last pick. This deck ended up a lot better than I thought it would be. I still wish I'd picked up a Worn Power Stone, but this looks pretty good. I think the mana is actually going to be fine, as opposed to trying to play double red cards. I'm just playing three single white cards, and I have a Coalition Relic, a Solemn, an Orzhov Signet, a Tundra, and a Mana Confluence. So I can play something like three planes. Yep, 10 and 3. Exactly what I was thinking. And the last card could either be Greaves or Hangerback. I think I'd rather play Greaves, but we'll see how this ends up going. And let's join the queue. Alrighty, welcome to round one. This hand is fine. The remand really holds it together, because if I can draw a white source, I can remand into spell color here. Whoa, turn on Mana Confluence. That's aggressive. Into Beaumont Courier. Okay, where are we going with this? Who knows? Okay, Jace doesn't do a whole lot for me. Guess it gives me a decent 4-mana play. So they kept a 1-lander? They had to have kept a 1-lander to play Confluence on turn 1. Sensei's Divining Top? I don't know what's going on here. Ooh, Coalition Relic was a really good draw. And they didn't spin the top either. Like, this is actually a good combo. You can spin the top, then exile the card you don't want to get to the cards you do. Blue-Black Beaumont Courier, huh? I have a hard time describing what's happening these first three turns, or understanding what's happening. But we'll see if we draw. If my opponent gives me something to remand. Sounds like they're going to. Oh, no, they're spinning the top. Spinning the top here. I get to remand this turn. I mean, even if they don't play anything, I'm just going to play Coalition Relic here. Oh, there's the Lightning Greaves. Big Greaves, huh? Let's just charge this. Charge this in F6. Alright, so now I'm surprised they didn't spin the top again. I mean, I guess this Beaumont Courier is kind of getting big. Into Karn, Sign of Urza. I actually would have liked to pick up Karn into a 3-3 construct. And then Beaumont Courier hits. Alright. So I have 6 mana. Might just play Jace here. And then plus Jace. And then play a land. And then now I can still charge Relic or remand. My choice, I would like to, so Jace is going to get hit for 3 here at most. I mean, assuming, well, not at most, because they could make a construct, and then the construct goes up to a 4-4, but they could also play an artifact. Though there's a pretty good chance I end up remanding it if they do. Okay, so they're going to plus Karn instead. I guess they can have a makeshift mannequin in their hand, and they can exile Sun Titan. Are they really running Beaumont Courier as like a reanimation enabler? Also, they have a weird Karn top artifact theme. I don't really know what their plan is, but I'm excited to find out. They didn't attack with Beaumont Courier? They could get a card under it. Okay. Well, I mean, I guess this works for me. Then Jace goes to 3, which means I could actually minus Jace next turn, potentially. Oh, and they play a Metamorph. I will remand the Metamorph. Because I want to find mana artifacts so I can make this upheaval good. But I guess I could have just charged that and played Battle Ball. Actually, that's a little awkward, because now if I play Battle Ball, they can copy it. Oh, well, this was kind of bad. This didn't do much for me. Oh, I'll take the Course of Portal. Let's Course of Portal and pass. And they can metamorph the Course of Portal. That's fine with me. I'm planning on potentially upheavaling next turn. I get to have 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. And if I can find a Grim Monolith, I get a little bit more. Actually, you know what? Maybe I shouldn't upheaval next turn. Because I could just, they copy the Course of Portal, then I play Battle Ball, then I upheaval 2 turns later. Yeah, that might be better. I, again, really don't know what their deck is trying to accomplish, so it's a little harder to say when I should do something. All right, here comes Metamorph for full retail. Yeah, they copy Course of Portal. And then they could minus Karn to make a Karn struct. Upheaval also kind of blanks out the extra cards they draw off Course of Portal. Oh, they're not making a thing. So they're hitting me with this, and they're killing Jace with the Bowmar Courier, sure. Well, that makes sense. They haven't used Karn yet, so curious to see where that goes. They're gonna spin the top first. Top Karn is a kind of nice little combo. You get to like top, put your good card on third place and your bad cards first two, and then you use Karn to clear off the two bad cards. And then eventually Karn picks something up too. My opponent's getting to see a lot of cards, but I'm unclear as to how that threatens me so far. Okay. They're gonna draw and then they're gonna plus Karn or. Yeah, I just officially don't know what's going on. Are they gonna sack Bowmite Courier? No, they just. Don't know what's happening. They didn't use Karn that turn, which, regardless of what their plans are, I suspect is not. I'm gonna vote Carnage just to see if my opponent votes Carnage with me. Is that Genius or Grifter? Voting Carnage here. All right, well, it didn't work. I draw out of blue, sure. I could play the Lodestone Golem. It's not too bad. Let's just play Battle Ball. And then we get to charge Relic. And potentially upheaval. I guess I could have gone like Greaves into Lodestone Golem and killed Karn. That'd be kind of funny. But playing Battle Ball seems like a pretty good plan here. And end of turn, they're sacking their Beaumont Courier, discarding Makeshift Mannequin, Emrakul, the Promised End, Mere Battlesphere. All right, and drawing a bunch of cards here. Sure, whatever. They get their extra card. I can't stop them. They have seven cards in their hand. That's a lot of cards. Next turn, I'll have access to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana pre-upheaval. And so I can just, at the very least, go upheaval relic. But I am not 100% sure what my plan is going to be. And here comes Karn Liberated. Okay. Well, that steals my Battlesphere. And they can make another Karn Sign of Urza token, I suppose. And then. Yeah, okay, sure, I can give you a Plains Mountain. My opponent's got a sweet deck. I'm jealous of this Karn Liberated, though. I can also kill Karn Liberated if I want to. Alright, whatever, I'll just pick Homage. Draw my extra card here. Ooh, Mana Crypt? Okay, that means we're definitely upheavaling then. Let's see, because I can play Mana Crypt. So now, let's see, I can go 5, 6, 7, 8 mana, and 10 mana. Upheaval with four floating, replay Mana Crypt, replay land, have seven mana. I could upheaval into Mere Battlesphere. In that case, I don't even think I need to attack my tokens first because I would rather get the extra mana. Because I think I just want to replay Mere Battlesphere. Oh wait, I don't have a Battlesphere anymore. Oh. Okay, new plan. Four mana, so I could play Relic, or I could just play Lodestone Golem, play Greaves, and inflict grievous injury on my opponent here with my Lodestone Golem. And hit for five, and then discard some islands. And the next turn I can just play like Coercive Portal or Solemn or whatever. And this works out just fine for me. All right, they went land top, and now they're gonna discard a million cards. Phyrexian Arena, yeah, sure. Next turn I just play Solemn because I can hit them for seven down to four, and then they have to have something pretty good to stop that from winning. Mana Crypt is obscene. I mean, Upheaval is also just a really messed up Magic card. But Manaheaval is a big part of that as well. Or sorry, Manaheaval, Mana Crypt. They're going to discard down to some amount here. All right, I can lose some coin flips here. I did lose the coin flip. Oh, Daze. Daze actually, I can't cast it because of my Lodestone Golem. Funny. Equip. And, well, hold on, actually, turn off auto yields because I'm going to hit for 7, but I want to actually move the Lightning Greaves back to the Lodestone Golem afterwards just to make sure it doesn't die. And they have to have, oh, they do have a blocker. Baleful Strix does keep them alive. I guess if I lose all of my coin flips here. Okay, I want the flip there. Oh, wait, no, never mind. They're actually dead. The old main phase Spell Queller. Haven't done that one yet, but I guess the Greaves did pretty good work here. All right, well, we beat a Reanimator-ish deck, and I don't think I want Hangar back or Lingering Zools given that information. I think we just battle. Alrighty, welcome to game 2 here, and well, we've got a pretty good hand. No Ancient Tomb or Mana Crypt here, but let's play Mutavault in that deck. Yeah, sure. Mutavault in a 4-color deck is medium ambitious, but counterpoint, who's at 18 now? That would be me. Let's play Simic Signet. And then next turn we can play Colas and Relic, or we can leave up Spell Queller. If I don't draw anything, I'd probably rather leave up Spell Queller. Yeah. Oh, I even get to play Plains, so I don't have to play that Mana Confluence, because if I play the Colas and Relic, I've got nothing big to play. And what if they, I don't know, what if they play like a Karn or something? The 4-mana Karn, of course. Here we go. Oh, already do this. I'm actually going to try to ambush here. No reason not to do that either. I get my card either way. And if this works, I destroy a land, which, bam. That worked out for me. All right. So all lands here, but Coalition Relic is a powerful card, and now if I draw some action, I just get to drop it, cast everything in my deck. I guess Upheaval wouldn't be the most effective. Here comes the Mana Confluence. I guess if you have Mana Confluence, it offsets the Mutavault, see? Baleful Strix. Well, probably not going to repeal the Baleful Strix, is my guess. I might repeal the Spell Queller at some point just to counter something. I'm just going to pass, because I could repeal Spell Queller here, but like with the Coalition Relic mana, but it doesn't change a whole lot and it might impact their plays. So let's just leave things be for the moment. I really do not have a lot of action going on here, do I? I felt like pretty good about this, but I guess the last couple turns I haven't hit anything new. And they're just going to pass? Or are they going to get in for one first? Getting their damage in. All right. I guess I'll take one that probably indicates a follow-up. If I had to guess, it's going to be a really bad one. They play Karn, I go repeal my Spell Queller, and then they Swords to Plowshares the Spell Queller. That'll be a beat. Show and Tell. I don't know what they want to show and or tell, but I'm not into it. Let's repeal Spell Queller and counter it. Ooh, here we go. Okay, you're gone. That original Spell Queller trigger had nothing attached to it, so that's gone. Means they have at least one gigantic thing in their hand. That's worth knowing. Oh, Remand is not bad either. Play the Course of Portal and hit for 2 with the Spell Queller. Why not? It would be funny if they played something big and then I just remove my Spell Queller to put Show and Tell in the stack and then I put something gigantic into play. That would be sweet. Probably going to play something big here. It'll probably romantic. Masterminds acquisition. Okay, I guess I'll allow them to do that. They search their library for anything. I could remand that, but it seems better to remand whatever they get. I guess if they get a cheap removal spell, that's a little worse for me. Either way, they could do it next turn, though. Also, if they play, like, Lightning Bolt, right, on Spellcaller, I just let that happen and then remand the show until. Either way, I buy myself a turn. So, don't feel too bad about the whole situation. Alright, they're gonna pass, huh? I will charge my relic, though. And this time I will in fact name homage. Because I really don't want things to go badly. Ooh. Okay, I could upheaval with a bunch of mana floating, but upheaval Spellcaller is actually not a good combo because then the... Well, no, I guess I'd have to have enough mana to counter that. So, yeah, let's just play Teferi. Let's solve that problem by just casting Teferi, Hero of Dominaria, drawing a card. Ooh. Let's play Metalworker. Maybe if we draw some artifacts, we can get a big upheaval going here. If I draw off, of course, a Portal of Teferi, some artifacts to reveal with Metalworker, and then that means we get to upheaval successfully. All right, so the opponent successfully tutored. Whatever this is, I'm going to counter it. Rakdos is returned for 5. Yeah, I'm going to remand that. That does put a time limit on me casting this upheaval, but oh yeah, now that I've even one artifact was going to be enough to have a sick upheaval, we're going to see way more than that. All right, this is the plan. So I do have to pay the extra for show and tell, unfortunately, but I think I'll be able to afford that because oh, 3 artifacts. All right, let's get white mana. Sure. Well, let's draw first with Teferi. Okay, reveal 1, 2, 3. Plagrim Monolith for 3, white, blue, upheaval. Okay, so now they cast Show and Tell, and then I re-spell queller it. And then I have 2, 5, 6, 3, 6, 8 mana, so 9 mana. So I guess if I play Monolith, 10 mana. I want to play the Battle Ball. Yeah, so I can play Battle Ball. Actually, hold on. What if I play Coalition Relic and then play Battle Ball? Yeah, that seems like the best. And then, oh, I could have played a land and a Signet too. I forgot I hadn't played a land yet. Well, whatever. Discard, 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 discard. Just discard all the islands. All the islands. And then now my opponent is, I guess, yeah, they're just dead next turn. I get to attack them for 12 with Mirror Battle Sphere plus the 2 off Spellqueller. And we have proved that artifact mana plus upheaval is a good combination. I hope you take that to heart when it comes to cube, and we are up a map. Alrighty, welcome to game 2. I would like to be on the play, and I want to tell you about the newsletter at ChannelFireball.com. If you go to, well, ChannelFireball.com/newsletter, you can sign up for a newsletter, which I'm going to keep this hand, written by yours truly. I always write about a deck or a strategy or specific cards that I think are sweet, whatever's going on in Magic that I think is awesome. And, we tend to put some special offers in there, and it's got a lot going on. So I'd suggest that you sign up for the newsletter. I think it's a great place to get a little bit more information, some entertainment, and some savings. So check out the newsletter. Like I said, channelfireball.com/newsletter. Ooh, I'm just going to play the Greaves here. See, it seems like it'd be a grievous mistake not to. Basically, I'm going to tap out next turn for Solemn, and then I can have Counterspell up after that. I don't care too much about whatever they can play on turn 2. Yeah, Gruul Signet's just fine. All right, let's... Simulacrum it up, and I guess I'll get a Plains here. Might as well. Equip Greaves and send. Bam. Let my opponent do as they wish. Let's hope this isn't too big. Garrick the Relentless. Okay, that's actually not so bad. So now, it's kind of interesting. If I attack Garrick, knocks Garrett down to one. It doesn't sound great for me, because then they can sack a creature and go get something. I think I'm just going to play Memory Jar. And I guess Tundra. And pass. I don't think I want to let them flip Garrick. I would obviously love if the wolf traded. That would be good for me. Slime Ball. Okay. So they're going to slime my Memory Jar. I don't think it's worth sacking. I can't play anything, and putting things in my graveyard doesn't seem all that valuable to me. So let's just chill. If they want to attack, I will block. We're looking for something here. Yes. Ooh, Jace, Architect of Thought. That's interesting. Academy, not really where I want to be. So I can play Jace. I guess Jace Plus is probably pretty good. Oh. Yeah. Actually, I did kind of tap that wrong, because I should have tapped a Tundra and left up Island in case they have Wasteland. It doesn't matter too much, though. So they can hit Jace down to 3 this turn, but next turn I'm going to be able to Jace counter whatever they play here. Actually, I think I'm going to let Sylvan Library go. Well, it's good, but I would rather save my counterspell for something a little bit bigger. Plaguecrafter. Okay, well, that I am going to counter, because otherwise I'm going to sack Jace, and I don't really want to do that. Alright, and they get to hit Jace for 2 damage. And now it's time for some action. Ooh, Grim Monolith. That means if I hit an Upheaval. Yes. Okay, I'm definitely taking Upheaval. So now, if I play Grim Monolith, I Upheaval with 2 mana floating. Oh, I guess I should have played Academy last turn. Well, let's see. Blue. So if Upheaval with 2 mana floating, I could play Academy and then replay Jace this turn. Or I think I'd rather hit my land drop. So let's just Upheaval, play Grim Monolith, play Ancient Tomb, play Lightning Greaves, pass the turn, discard Plains, and then next turn I can go Talarian Academy, play play Jace, Architect of Thought. Upheaval's just how I'm going to win all my games, apparently. But that's also just because Upheaval's just a busted card. Yeah, I just go land and I have to discard 4 cards. Including Wall of Roots. Interesting. Alright, they've got a Slime Ball in hand. Got to remember that. So this Ancient Tomb's also been doing some pretty good work. Now I'm just going to start Jacing. I think I want Ballista more than anything else, since I have a lot of mana and I can play a fairly large Ballista. What are they going to play here? A Gruul Signet, I guess, is likely the play. So what do I do now? Oh, Daze is going to be nice. So now I definitely want to play Island. So right now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. Let's plus Jace, because I don't need to draw something this turn. So I could... Do I want to just play 2, 2... Oh, wait, no. 2, 4, 5, 8 mana. Never mind. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's just make a huge Ballista here. Whoop. X is 4. Greaves has kind of been pulling its weight here. I guess it didn't do much earlier, but in the previous match, I was able to get an extra hit in. And here, getting an extra hit in seems like it's pretty good. I can also start pumping the Ballista with Talarian Academy here. Liliana. Thank you, Signets. All right, I'm going to Daze Liliana. And they cannot pay because Gruul Signet cannot intrinsically tap for mana. Technically, they should have floated mana. They're just going to concede. I think out of shame, next turn I have 3, 4, 5, 6. I can put... I have enough to just actually lethal them with Ballista. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm going to put Hangerback in, because Hangerback really gets Liliana and Plaguecrafter. So I've got a couple ways to do that. I could also... It's not insane to think of splashing Lingering Souls. I can put in that Concealed Courtyard, and I have Orzhov Signet. But, despite Daze's best efforts there, do I want to take Daze out? Acidic Slime is good against me. You can just all artifacts. Daze is still pretty good. Though, maybe I'm on the draw now, and they'll be scared of Daze. Maybe we'll just take it out there. Alright, this hand, a little less explosive than the other one. just because it doesn't have Ancient Tomb. But I guess I still have turn two Monolith into Coalition Relic if I want. Obviously, if I draw Ancient Tomb, this hand just goes off. I could also just turn two Monolith, turn three Relic, turn four Mirror Battle Sphere. That's not so bad. Let's play the Grim Monolith. I just don't know. Like, I don't care about countering Garruk here, for example. So I don't know what they can play that's like super threatening. Yeah, Karn's fine. Like, I would have loved to put Karn in this deck, but you can have a Vampire Nighthawk. I just don't care about that card. Blast Zone can't kill the tokens, but can kill, like, Grim Monolith, I guess. Oh, Metalworker. Oh, let's just play Metalworker. I would have played that last turn if I had it, and leave up Counterspell. And then next turn, we can use Metalworker to play play the Mirror Battlesphere here. Actually, next turn, I'll 4/8. I guess I don't have enough mana. You can have a Swamp. So they have Garruk, Relentless, and Blast Zone sitting under the Karn. Because next turn I'll have 3, 4, 8 mana. I go down to 5. So if I draw an artifact, I can play Coalition Relic. Currently, I can't play Coalition Relic. Is this a Slime Ball? Oh, Mind Twist. No. We're not doing that. Sorry. Mind Twist is fine and all, but I'll pass on that. Ooh, there we go. So let's go. Reveal. 3. So I have 6, 10 mana, so I can't play Battlesphere Solemn, but I can play Coalition Relic Battlesphere. And I guess I'll play this. Play the Battle Ball and charge the Relic, why not? Now if they want, they can pull Garruk off of Karn and kill my Metalworker, but Metalworker's already done its whole song and dance. And then they could also play Vampire Nighthawk to block the Mirror Battlesphere, which I suppose is fine. Yeah, you can have another Swamp, sure. Yeah, and even if I didn't give them the Nighthawk earlier, they could have pulled it off of Karn this turn if they had so desired. So, Morph, huh? Interesting. That doesn't help me much. Just play the Solemn. Oh, I guess I... okay, I guess I should have actually tapped Metalworker to untap the Coalition Relic first. All right, let's attack Karn. Tap all the Mirror. Because this is going to hit Karn for 4, trade for the Nighthawk, and then next turn... I can maybe try to kill Karn with my various things. I could use an Upheaval here. I guess trading off the Battlesphere does make Upheaval worse, so maybe I shouldn't have done that, but it kind of felt wrong just to sit there and do nothing. What are they going to get? Garruk, take out that Metalworker, I guess. Let's just charge Coalition Relic here. I guess they could also just make a Wolf at this point. The Metalworker's not doing anything. Though they might want to flip Garruk. Yeah, making a Wolf seems better against all these tokens. And now they're gonna play an Incubation Druid. Okay. Seems like this my opponent's deck is almost never gonna beat Upheaval if I just draw it. But did not do that here. And I should just keep playing lands in case I do draw that Upheaval. Attack. Karn. I'm just gonna attack. I guess I could have done that more efficient. I'm going to attack Karn with everything. They have to eat 2 tokens, and then they have to make some choices. Basically, I just want to get my Solemn Simulacrum killed off, because I really want to draw a card. Because now, if they want, I guess they can keep Karn at 1. Okay, they're going to lose their Wall of Roots. Okay. Guess I can go for that. I'll flip Den Protector. Pick back up Vampire Nighthawk, sure. And pass the turn. Because I have a lot of mana. I have 5, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12. Alright. They get to flip Garruk. So they have now access, because they just can pay -1 loyalty. They can't do it this turn because Garruk already did something. But -1 loyalty and sack a creature to go get another creature, which presumably is what they're going to be doing here soon. I can pump the Incubation Druid too. Well, my opponent's doing stuff, but I don't really know. You can have a kite cell freebooter if you want. I don't have anything in my hand. Not that I really care about getting acidic slimed either, to be honest. Besides upheaval, what is a good draw? I suppose most card draw type deals. Alright, so we're going to put counters and incubation druid. I think it's obvious I don't have anything in hand. Gaunty? Uh-oh. That's dangerous. They get to look at my top four cards, put basically one exiled face down. The other three go into the bottom of my deck. But if they hit upheaval there, that's bad news. And are they going to send? I really want to get my card off this Solemn at some point here. I guess next turn we'll see what we draw, huh? Lodestone Golem. Better not to. I'll just attack Solomon to Garrick the Veilcursed. They're going to give me my card one way or another here. Alright, draw. Upheaval. That's not an upheaval. Play a Lodestone Golem and pass, and they can Kite Sail Freebooter me, I suppose. They're also a pretty good upheaval deck now that they have Incubation Druid active. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Oh, wait, are they going to upheaval and not play? No, there's no way. If they upheaval before playing Freebooter, oh, that would have been so good, because then I could remand it back to my hand. Oh, it just feels like they have the upheaval, too. No, but they wouldn't have done that without using the Planeswalkers first. Well, I guess they're going to Freebooter me again. They're going to play a Signet. Sure. They can still Freebooter me here. Still have outs to draw people. We'll see what they're going to do. They're going to sack a wolf token. Wolf is colorless. Is it? No. No, it is not. This is a lie. What did I get in here? We'll find out momentarily. What did they get? Emrakul, the Promised End. No, I don't have enough mana to do that. Okay, they get to take my Course of Portal. And send. I could trade with Lodestone Golem. I'll just take it, because if I draw upheaval, I really want this Lodestone Golem to be able to get pulled into my head, or into my hand. And they're going to use Karn and pick up a Acidic Slime. So I should probably draw upheaval here, huh? Alright, that'll do it. I'm curious what they revealed. What my exiled card was. I guess I can draw to see if upheaval was in my deck somewhere. Oh, it was still. Alright, I like Days a little more on the play. Am I running too many lands? It's possible I am. I have Signet, Monolith, Mana Crypt. Yeah, I could probably take out a land. Probably should have done that to begin with. I don't think I want Lingering Souls, by the way. This is doesn't like seems like their deck goes big enough. I can probably do better. Actually, I'm going to take out Lightning Greaves and put in Tezzeret. I think Tezzeret has the possibility of being sweet here. Probably going to draw. I was going to say draw Days instead of an island and be in bad shape. All right, we're going to keep this hand. Remand into Coalition Relic into Spellcaller, or some combination of those things, is pretty good. Ancient Tomb still be a busted draw. Memory Jar is interesting, because Memory Jar at least gives me something to play with all this Coalition Relic mana. Turn 2, Blast Zone. Oh yeah, I'm definitely remanding Incubation Druid. Now what? Now I think I just pass, and I'm going to Spellcaller their Incubation Druid, if that is indeed what they're playing. And draw. Ooh, Lodestone Golem. Alright, why don't I just play that? That actually seems awesome. I just go on the offense. They can't play a 4-drop next turn. It makes something like Liliana a lot less scary. Because if they play Liliana of the Veil, I can sack Spellqueller, then they can't play the Incubation Druid because of the Bloodstone Golem. Let's see what they've got here. Sylvan Library? Well, that doesn't bother me too much. Okay, so now land. I'm going to hit for 7 here, and I think I just play Memory Jar and pass, because no reason to play Grim Monolith into Memory Jar. That just, you know, causes me to take or lose a card. And then next turn, I mean, I could have just gone Relic into Grim Monolith, I suppose, but I kind of want to just jar and just get some action going. I could stop on upkeep because I get an extra card, but I actually would rather wait, I think. All right, what's gonna happen here? Somehow I turned into Artifact Beatdown this game. Remand into Spellcaller into Lodestone Golem. They have Assassin's Trophy. Okay. Well, that's cool. I get a land. A land out of the deal is actually pretty nice. Okay, let's draw. Ooh, Teferi. Well, why don't I hit for 2? And then I'm just going to play Teferi here and draw. Well, I could also Coalition Relic. Yeah, why don't I just go Coalition Relic into Teferi? Yeah, I'm slightly short of going Teferi, or Monolith into Teferi, then untapping Monolith with my extra lands here. I'm just going to draw. Ooh, Fracture Identity is a nice one too. Because look, this way I have a much more mana available for Memory Jar shenanigans, because I have a relic in play and hit an extra land drop. And if my opponent goes like Acidic Slime your Memory Jar, well, then I have a Teferi that I'm drawing extra cards with, so I'm not too worried about that. Yeah, I think I just let that happen. They haven't played a land yet, so that could give them a land drop. Okay, let's draw a card. Talarian Academy. Interesting. So if I go land, Academy, I can Fractured Identity the Acidic Slime. And then I get an Acidic Slime, and then I'm just going to kill their black lands. Because now I get to hit them down to 2 and kill them with some dorks. All right, we are on to the finals. Alrighty, welcome to round 3. Let's see if we can get ourselves a trophy. And oh, this hand looks very capable of doing so. We've got basically a nice little mono blue artifact ramp deck here with Teferi and Spellqueller as my white cards. Upheaval, of course, being the star of the show. Haven't had too many explosive mana crypt openings, but even mid game with Upheaval, mana crypt is really nice. Okay, so land. I think I'm just going to Signet here. This could go wrong. So my other option is to just go Ballista, ping your elf. Problem with that is if I don't hit a land next turn, I don't get to have any other plays. And then also with Metalworker in hand, I kind of want to just play Metalworker and then play a gigantic Ballista. We'll see. Turn 2 Tireless Tracker. All right. Oh, there's the Mana Crypt. Let's see. I think I'm just going to play Metalworker and pass the turn and hope beyond hope that my opponent does not kill Metalworker, because next time I would have such a good turn next turn if they don't. I'll give them one Tireless Tracker turn here. That Mana Crypt earlier, if I had turn 1 Metalworker, we could have gotten some stuff going. But next turn I'll have 3, 9, 11 mana. I can do something like play 3-3 Ballista and a Corrosive Portal. I can also like play Teferi plus Ballista or something along those lines. Take it. All right, what are they going to do? They're going to tap out for Coercive Portal. Okay, I can deal with that. Oh, another artifact would be really funny. All right, let's tap this. Reveal those 3. So I have 6 mana. Really 11. What if I play Teferi and a 3-3 Ballista and I kill all their stuff? Is that good? I could let them keep the Elves of Deep Shadow, maybe. And I get to untap 2 lands and have Remand up, too. No, I should just kill the Elves of Deep Shadow. All right. Let's go Ballista. 3-3. Yoink. Yoink. And yoink. And then now, Mana Crypt. Oh no, I'm not going to have the lands on top. Never mind. Also, Signets are horrible. Teferi. And put Course of Portal back. Bam. Well, that was a good turn, I would say. I didn't even play a land. Had I drawn an artifact that turn? Oof. That's just getting greedy, though. Look at that. We get to... Our Metalworker worked hard for his money there. What are they going to do? Lingering Souls? Well, Lingering Souls is actually a pretty solid way to attack Teferi. Now I wish I had my Walking Ballista back to draw. Wow, I'm not going to be able to save my Teferi. That's a shame. All right, so this is enough mana. I'm going to go Solemn for an island here. Well, I think I'll still be fine, even though I'm sadly losing Teferi. Because then I'm going to play Course of Portal. And play Grim Monolith, because remember, I'm untapping two lands with Teferi here, so I'm going to be able to have a counter spell up still. If they didn't have Lingering Souls, I would run away with this game. But I think, as is, I'm still feeling pretty good about it. Metamorphose? Ooh. Nice. I like what my opponent's got going on. They're flashing back Lingering Souls with Metamorphose and Elves of Deep Shadow. Though if they flash back Lingering Souls, Remand is the perfect answer to that. Let's see. Land, and... Yeah, we'll Remand that, because that means it is never coming back. Okay, island's not really what I wanted. I cracked their clue. They'll hit Teferi here, which is a shame. All right, bye Teferi. You did serve me well. You drew me a card and removed a Course of Portal. All right, well, I'm going to name... Well, heads, lose the flip. Homage, draw my extra card. Miscalc and Coalition Relic. I'm going to cycle Miscalc here. Because I'm looking for action. Jeez, that's some action. All right, land. I'm just going to hit. I'm not going to play the Coalition Relic because I think I'd rather just have it in hand in case I draw Upheaval here. Which certainly is a card I wouldn't mind drawing. I'm on a little bit of a clock, especially if that Celestial Colonnade heads my way. Like, if they just hit me with Colonnade here, that would be worse for me. I kind of... don't think I care about Course of Portal. Oh, Master of the Wild Hunt. Nah, that's actually fine. They can pick off my Metalworker if they want. All right. I would like to win this flip, though. All right, whew, won that flip. I'm going to draw Upheaval, Upheaval, Upheaval. Lodestone Golem Island. Sure, I actually don't even know if I want to play Lodestone Golem, because that makes it more likely they use Celestial Colonnade. So I think I'm just going to pass here. Because if they hit with Colonnade, I'm a coin flip away from dying. Which, I don't like the sound of that. Because they get to hit me for 6 in the air, and then I have Mana Crypt to contend with. Okay, Metalworker down. Okay, they didn't hit me with the Colonnade, thankfully. And I don't think I counter the Course of Portal, because again, I think I'm really just looking for Upheaval here, and that doesn't matter. Yeah, Pilgrim's fine too. All right. Let's see. Tails, I won the flip. Okay, so I'm not just dead. Homage, Upheaval, Upheaval, Upheaval. Greaves, Island. Really don't want to play Lodestone Golem all that much because... No, I probably should, though. And sure, I'll play Greaves also. Greaves the Lodestone Golem and pass. I guess my opponent could technically swing for lethal here if they attacked with everything. Not that I think they would do that, because, but we'll see. Because I could block Master and Wolf and... Oh, they're going to Mystical Tutor. I like that. Whatever's going on here, I like this. Because Mystical Tutor is something that implies they're not attacking Ancestral Colonnade, which is, again, what I don't want to have happen. I would just be dead by now if my opponent was just doing that. What did he even get a Mystical Tutor for here? I guess a removal spell or something? I mean, who knows? I would love if my Solemn Simulacrum died somehow. The other thing is I can also draw, like, Jace or Memory Jar. Ugh, Memory Jar would be obscene here. How much mana do I have? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 artifacts. That's already 8, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 19, 21, 22 mana. Yeah, I'm going to say that Upheaval does the trick. Oh, they got Mana Drain. Well, that's a powerful card. I guess it's good to know about it, but it's not really going to do much here. I still have Counterspell in hand, which means I have to not use the... I'll have to keep the Mana Drain in mind. They can no longer hit for lethal unless they have a land. Because right now they have to tap the Avacyn's Pilgrim in order to animate the Celestial Colonnade. I feel like if I'm them, I'm reading me as having nothing in hand. So I might be tempted just to leave up Counterspell instead of attacking Celestial Colonnade. It just turns out that I've got this Counterspell I've been sitting on because none of my opponent's cards have really changed what I need to do to win the game. But we'll see what they go for here. All right, they're not going to try to kill me. Send me down to 5. And pass the turn. Oh, they could have gone for lethal. All right. Charge my relic. All right. Let's see what we hit here. I won the flip. All right, nice, nice. Been getting kind of lucky there. Upheaval, upheaval, upheaval. Now I don't think my opponent could get it wrong. I know what my top card is. I mean, it's going to be Upheaval. No. Well, next turn I would have hit Upheaval. Maybe this deck does just have too many lands. All right, I'll take out an island. And against what I saw there, I guess Lingering Souls could be good. I could put in the Concealed Courtyard over a Plains. I could just put in Tezzeret. Tezzeret's sweet. All right. Alrighty, welcome to game two. I would like to play first. Yeah, I'm going to keep most hands that have Ancient Tomb and a good 4-drop. And that last game, that was rough. That was rough. We were drawing 2 cards a turn, and all the drawing 2 cards a turn meant is I got to brick twice a turn. This is a turn 3 Golem on the play, which is pretty nice. We'll see. Oh no, are they gonna... I thought they were gonna have Island, and Mana Drain. Looks like they kept a hand without green. Now I draw Mana Crypt? You're mocking me. Mocking me, I say. Play Lodestone Golem. Pretty good chance they can't play anything next turn. But also I think they just kept a hand without green mana, but we'll see. If they play like an elf this turn, then that's definitely what happened. Oh, path? Sure. I suppose I will accept, since I have no other options. Ooh, Simic Signet. So what if I go Signet into a Memory Jar, and then next turn I'm going to have lots of manas. I guess I actually should have played Talarian Academy. I always like slow rolling Talarian Academy because of Wasteland concerns, but it actually seems like it would have been better to just play it there because it doesn't matter too much. I'll just play Academy before cracking Jar. Ooh, Hero of Bladehold. Alright, that's a card. Let's see if we can defeat that, huh? Mana Crypt. Academy. Just gonna crack the Jar. I'm not gonna course the portal here. Yeah, we're gonna be fine. Let's go Grim Monolith. So right now I'm on 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13 mana. And right now I've got 10 mana worth of play. So let's start by going Repeal on Hero. Repeal plus Jar is a nice combo. Remand's not gonna do much for me. And then let's go Greaves and Teferi. I guess I'll draw a card in case I draw... Oh, no. Oh, no. I was hoping to draw something to play this turn, but now I'm going to discard Upheaval to Jar. Well. Whew. All right. We'll have to win the game without Upheaval. No easy mode. We got this. They discarded Mana Confluence, Spell Queller, Hero Blade Hold, Repeal. Okay. Let's see what we can hit here. We're at 16, so Mana Crypt's not a huge issue. Teferi can mine us there. If I need to, yeah, there's a Trigon. I'll probably be sending that one back. Let's untap my Grim Monolith. Ooh, no upheaval, huh? Well, get you out of here and then play Course of Portal and I guess play a land and we're looking for Walking Ballista now. That, in fact, would be the jam. I'm going to get to draw three cards next turn, which is nice. The goose is loose. All right. No, I've won a lot of coin flips. That is cool. Draw. Jace, draw. Draw Teferi. I'll cycle Miscalc. And let's see. Actually, that's tapping really badly, I think. Let's go Simic Signet Island. There we go. Jace, I'm just going to minus Jace. I need to draw something. There we go. I'll take a Battle Ball. And now we can tap Academy. Oh yeah, we get to Battle Ball out of control. Lightning Greaves is looking nice here. Because now I get to go Greaves, hit, and I'll let my Planeswalkers die if that's what's needed. Hit my opponent for 12 here, then next turn I'm going to get to untap some land, so I still have Counterspell for whatever they do this turn, and then they definitely have to do something, or they just die to Mirror Enforcer. Geist can kill both my Planeswalkers. Oh, whatever this is, I'm countering this. I can't think of something that would cost 5 mana that I wouldn't want to counter here. Oh. Except Mirai's Wake? Yeah, I mean, actually, Mirai's Wake is fine. Never mind, my opponent saw the line. They found the one thing that I don't care about. And Parallax Wave, yes, that I do care about. Okay. So now they can't even attack with Geist of St. Traft. Ooh, we won without upheaval. Okay. I don't think I want Linvala or Hangerback Walker, so yeah, I mean, I guess we're good. Like, the Geist of St. Traft will be annoying if they land one of those early, but I think my opponent's deck is not the most focused, whereas our deck is very focused. Okay, this looks good. The card I most want to draw here, of course, is Mana Crypt, as always. Oh no, they have turn one Mana Dork. That's unfortunate. This is going to be tough. I mean, it depends on how fast their hand is. If they have turn two Geist, sure, I might just die. But if they don't, I've got a decent chance here. Because I've got some powerful cards. Also, if I draw Mana Crypt. Counterspell. I suppose I could also just not draw castable cards at all. White mana, what do they got here? Turn three, Mirai's Wake, and now I draw. All right, well, this is gonna be hard, but you know what? It depends on what my opponent does next turn, because I've got Fractured Identity to steal their Mirai's Wake. If they don't have something obscene this turn, they can't play Hero of Bladehold. If they have Geist of St. Traft, presumably they would have already played it. I mean, we'll find out. Course of Portal, I think I can live with that. Avacyn's Pilgrim, sure. And if they have Spell Queller, I guess, actually, you know what? Spell Queller doesn't do the trick here. So let's go ahead and draw my card. I'm gonna vote for Carnage anyway, just because if they vote for Carnage randomly, that would be sweet. Fractured Identity or Mirai's Wake. Because look at it this way. Now I have Mirai's Wake and I have Upheaval. And it cuts off a lot of their mana. It's a shame that Upheaval will kill my own Mirai's Wake, but, you know, that's a sacrifice I can make. Because next turn I'll have access to, let's see, 9 before playing a land. So that's like a pretty solid Upheaval. And if I wanted to use my land drop, I could get 11 mana. I mean, 11 mana is Upheaval Teferi. Though I guess I could go Upheaval Ancient Tomb Teferi. That's probably better. I mean, I guess Upheaval's not actually that great against Avacyn's Pilgrim. It might also be better just to go, like, Jace plus Teferi plus leave Counterspell up. I mean, it'll really depend on what they play this turn. If they play Geist of St. Traft or Hero of Bladehold, that's a very different position than them casting a Mana Morphos and doing who knows what. So we'll see what they're up to. I'm hoping they don't kill my Mirari's Wake. Okay, yeah, Hero of Bladehold will prompt some action here. Okay, I go to 10. Get to draw two cards. I'll vote for Carnage again, just because Mize. Okay, so that doesn't change anything. So now, so I go 3, 5, 7, 9. Upheaval with 3 floating. Ancient Tomb to Teferi. Yeah, I think so. I mean, I guess I could also play... oh, they have Mana Drain? Alright, that's going to change my my plays a little bit. Unfortunately, it means that I'm no longer going to have the Nut post-upheaval turn, so I'm just going to have to play Greaves here. I mean, I can't... I just nothing I can do about that. Like, I can't, obviously can't let them Mana Drain here. Now at least they get to play a Mana Dork, but we're kind of back at the beginning of the game, except, yeah, I'm just a lower life total. That's basically it. I need to draw, like, a Signet or a Metalworker. Bloodstone Golem is not the actual worst, but I'm going to need a little bit more than that. So now I know they have Hero of Bladehold, Course of Portal, Elves Deep Shadow, Avacyn's Pilgrim. Would have been lovely to draw Walking Ballista, though I think a Walking Ballista here would also be pretty good. Okay. Walking Ballista is, I think, my number one choice. Tezzeret's not it. So if I go to 5... I hit them, then they hit me back for 2, I go to 3. So I probably don't want to hit them. I am going to play Ancient Tomb. The question is, what do I do with it? I think that the answer is just to play Jace and plus Jace. Because now they can hit me or Jace for 1, though I guess with us having the same loyalty, they probably want to hit me. They can play their Hero of Bladehold. Next turn I can Teferi bounce the Hero of Bladehold. And plus Jace again. Don't like the way this game is going, unfortunately. My opponent's deck is all over the place, but they drew a lot of Mana Dorks, which means that they're going to be able to rebuild post-upheaval here. Yeah, them having that Mana Drain was rough. Oh, they didn't attack? Okay, that's really good. The Jace scared them off of attacking. That might happen again. I mean, I have to bounce the heroes regardless, so I think I'd rather just plus Jace, put hero away, and then pass the turn. And there's a non-zero chance that they don't realize that with the Exalted from Noble Hierarch they can kill Teferi. If that happens, maybe I'm in okay spot. Daze is going to be pretty bad here, though. Oh, they're just going to animate Celestial Colonnade and kill me. Good beats, I guess. I guess that'll do it. All right. We lost a pretty rough finals there. Game one just drew millions of lands. But Ancient Tomb comes with a price, and that is the price we paid. So another finals appearance, no trophy yet, but I'll be trying to get one. Thanks for watching, everyone. You can find more videos like this on ChannelFireball.com, and I will